Okay, hello.
Player.
Hey, hello YouTube players. Engineering formula for a cantilevered beam analysis, and if we eliminate the variables such as force and the geometrical variables A and L, the only thing left to know is E and I. E is the value for the modulus of elasticity or material strength, and I, the moment of inertia, is a measure of the object's resistance to bending or flexural deformation because of its geometrical stiffness. It is as important to know where these values come from as well as to follow the units. E, or the modulus of elasticity, will be the easiest to track down. I, or the moment of inertia, can also be a source value. However, when you start to need custom profile solutions for strength to space allowances and aesthetic reasons, then you might need to calculate those values. FEM does all that, I hear you say. And you're right, it can, if you know what you're doing. And I'll walk you through an example later on. But I didn't get to this confidence level without trial and error. And this is why there are 3 years of theoretical formulas before computer analysis in college. What we're going to do is set up a spreadsheet to calculate the I value for the profiles before we take our results and compare them with an FEM analysis. And start with a simple rectangular section. To achieve a full parametric control over your design, it is essential to assign aliases to the height and the width. These aliases can then be incorporated into the dimension formula editor within the sketch, enabling dynamic updates based on changes to the parameter values. Once the height and the width values are properly referenced, you can easily calculate the centroid moment of inertia by internally using these parameters in the required formula. Since the shape in question is relatively simple, no further calculations or adjustments are necessary. The second stage, eye calculation, is used for complex shapes. It's really quite interesting, but outside the scope of this video. I like to change any calculated cell to green, indicating that it's good. Go, no need to stop here. And with the dark theme, variables automatically turn blue. But that's the color I'd change them to if they didn't. By adding a few dimensions to our spreadsheet, we increase the parametric control of our model. I think it's good practice to label meaningfully and keep a similar alias, which helps with writing formulas in the dimension editor. So once they are all assigned, we just need to imagine some suitable values. Let's go with 950mm for A and 1250mm for L and 1500N of force. We will pad the sketch at the L distance, and we're done, right? No, not quite. As we want to run an FAA simulation in the FEM workbench, this will require a little extra prep. First, we need to allow for the anchorage in the wall. So basically, we can just pad the face at the end of the beam by the anchorage amount added at the spreadsheet, making sure to go under the properties menu and setting refine to false. Also, we need to set up a face to assign the load to. Sorry peeps, I'll have to jump ahead on this one. I found a bug in the spreadsheet. If I change the height to 300, it throws the entire calculation into error. bug number 14. I've lost count. Writing formulas with the correct syntax in the spreadsheet cell is a bit of a dark art, so I'll endeavor to put the formulas under the cell for your reference. And some instances, if you get stuck, it might be best to break up the calculation into separate cells. In the FEM analysis, we now have the material assigned and the fixed constraints and the force constraints. We just need to mesh the body now. Either option works, and I'll use a moderate G mesh. Write the INP file and run Calculex. We can see that the results are very similar. A finer mesh would have brought the comparison closer. Calculex gave us a result of 0.82, and the analytical formula gave us a result of 0.79 for the deflection. Close enough to know that we're on the right track for the two results to establish calibration. FEM gave us a one meter stress of 2.11 megapascals, and the combined stress formulas gave us a result of 2.14 megapascals. Again, close enough to be able to sleep at night. So what would we use something like this for? A staircase is a good example. If you consider half the tread that could be analyzed when there was a need to change the width or the going, both of these files are parametric, so we can purge the previous results at any time, remesh the new geometry and rerun Calculex. If we change the tread height to 50mm and the width of the tread to 300mm, this might be something that would resemble a stair tread. Potentially not the exact loading that you would use, and that would depend on your codes. But what I'm showing here is that even on a development version of FreeCAD, you can get stuff done. And discovering bugs is a rewarding contribution to the very valuable FreeCAD project. Remeshing and rewriting the IMP file and then rerunning the solver, we notice again that the results are very similar, 16.83 and 16.9. When I clear this very strange bug again, from a different cell this time, and 10.77 megapascals and 11.44 megapascals, both could be rounded to 11 megapascals, so that's good enough for preliminary engineering. What I did want to show you is that when you assign restraints and forces to faces or surfaces, they are and remain parametric, which makes fine-tuning and rerunning a problem just that little bit easier. And when you consider the difficulty redrawing by hand or Cartesian coordinates CAD and rerunning hand calcs that engineers used to have to do by abacus, it's really a great time to be alive. And I don't know who I'm in awe of more, the guys who used to use the abacus or the guys writing the FreeCAD software. If you got some useful info from this video, please don't hesitate to like and subscribe. And if you head over to Patreon, you can purchase this file. It's really the same as buying me a coffee. Speaking of coffee, and if you would like to purchase something tangible in return for your support, check out this mug over on eBay. It's guaranteed to bring a laugh to your workplace or a punch up. I take no responsibility for either though. Another way to support the channel is via PayPal donations. Thanks for watching. Also, support the FreeCAD project if you can, and I hope to see you on another video soon.